So what is your opinion, guys? Okay, now let's start with today's class. Let us not do it. Already 7 minutes up now. What we have discussed in the last class is, you know, FE tree, right? We have discussed in the last class. I'll just share the screen. Okay, I think screen is already shared, right? You can see my screen, just yes or no. You can see the screen, please type yes or no. We can see the screen, yes or no, please type. Okay, let's start. Okay, see, last class what you have discussed is an FE tree. This is the last topic we need to discuss today. Okay, we'll finish up module number 3 also. We have discussed how to construct how to come up with a frequent item set and how to construct a FE tree, that we have discussed in the last class. Now today we discuss about mining frequent patterns using FE tree. Okay, the process goes like this during the mining stage. So start from each frequent length n, length one, okay, pattern, as in the initial suffix pattern. So with an example, you can able to understand this. The different steps I mentioned it, just you understand what are these steps, then with an example you can able to understand very clearly. So first step is start from each frequent length one. Okay, we come up with the first item set, right? First item set, we start from the frequent length one pattern, then construct this conditional pattern whose, okay, here the conditional base is something about a sub base which consists of the set of prefix path in the FE tree co-occurring in the suffix pattern. Okay, then step number 3, construct its FE tree, conditional FE tree we'll call it as. Okay, construct its FE tree, it's a conditional FE tree, and perform mining recursively on such a tree. Okay, then step number 4 is supposed to be the pattern growth is achieved by concatenation of suffix pattern with the frequent patterns generated from the conditional FE tree. Now these are some of the steps. So we'll discuss with one example, then you can able to understand. Okay, one of an example I've taken here. Let us start with the last. That is maybe one of an item set we have taken it here. Let us start with the least frequent. Okay, that means just wait for 2 minutes. ನಾನು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಹೋಗು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಬತ್ತೆ, ಹೋಗು ಮಾರಯ್ಯ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ನಾನು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಹೋಗು.
ಜಸ್ಟ್ 2 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್.
ಸೌಮ್ಯ ಅವ್ನು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಮಾರೈತಿ, ಹೋಗು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಬತ್ತೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು.
ಸಾರಿ ಗೈಸ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಯು ನೋ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, start with the last item order. We'll start with the P. For this you need to come up with the conditional conditional set here. Okay, we'll call it a conditional pattern. Now in the conditional patterns, what happens, if you see this particular example, wait for 2 minutes. Okay, so here what happens, we'll start with the P. Okay, we let us see, follow the node pointers and traverse only the path containing P. Now you have to traverse it wherever the path only P is there, the P path you have to traverse it. Let us if you see this particular example, the P starts from here. This is the one P, right? One more P is here. You traverse along this particular P. Now what happens, P value here in this particular case is 2. Okay, see, in this particular case is what is 2, and in this particular case is 1. Now what is actually a support count we have assumed in the previous is the same example which you discussed earlier. Support count what you have assumed is what, 2. Now which is the one sub, satisfies the support count here? Only this one will satisfy, right? Only this one will satisfy support count, right? And this one will not satisfy because the p value is equal to 1 here. This p value is equal to 2 in this case. So p value is equal to 2, that means 2 is equal to 2. So support count, it it satisfies. So what we supposed to do, we have to find out the path for this p. We have to find out the path for this. What is the path for this? it starts from F, okay? Then you have a C. It starts from like this. Okay, it starts from like this. So this is F, first F, then it comes to C3, then comes to A, then comes to M, then it reaches to P here. That's what we have mentioned here. You can see in this case, FC, FCAM, right? FCAM is equal to 2. Why it is 2? FCAM here, why it is become 2? See, P value is 2, right? That is why FCAM is equal to 2 here. FCAM equal to 2. That means the occurrence I'm talking about. Whatever the number you have mentioned here, 2 times FCAM occurred here. That's what we mentioned. Frequent sets. Then what is the other case here? Other P is here, right? This is the other P. Now what is the path for this? You have to traverse it. C, then B. CB, this is the path. Now CB is the path. Then CB is equal to how much? CB, is it occurred once. The frequency of this CB is equal to only 1. Right? This is what you have written the conditional pattern based for the P now. You got it? What is the conditional pattern for this P? Right? And is it recording? Yes. So conditional pattern for P is equal to, this case is supposed to be CB. Now the CB, it appeared once here. This case, FCAM is appeared for 2 times here. Right? So that is what we have mentioned it. Now, what is supposed to do, since this one is not satisfied because the support count is only 1 here. This case, the support count is only 1. But what is our threshold value? Threshold value taken as 2. Now, because of the threshold value is equal to 2, this value will not satisfy. We're going to take it only this value. That's what I mentioned here. Construct a new FE tree based on this pattern by merging all the paths and keeping nodes that appear greater than or equal to support times. That means the threshold value what you have taken. Threshold value, you have assumed that 2. You have taken as 2, right? This leads to only one branch. That means C3. Thus, we derive only one frequent set here, P, pattern CP. Now, since it is only, this is satisfies, what we are going to do? We are going to take only C here. Why it is C? Because the P is under C, right? For example, this P is also under this C, and this P is also under this C. It comes under this. So that is the reason why you're taking C as the base item here. C as the base item, because P also comes under C here. And here also P comes under C. So that is the reason why C we are taking as the base item. So only since this is satisfied, what happens? C is equal to 3. This is what we have taken it. So for this, you have to construct a conditional tree. Got this? Let us take one more example for M. Move next to the frequent item, maybe a least frequent item in order is M. Let us assume they take an item of M. Now what happens, what is the M value? You have to traverse it. Wherever M item is there, you need to traverse it. This is the first M item, right? Then you have another M item. You traverse along with this. See, you have to traverse along this here. M comes here, right? This is the one. Then it goes to B, then comes under here. Now what happens here, this case, you, like a previous one, M value is equal to 12. M occurred 2 times here, which comes under, okay, which comes under F, C, A, and M. You traverse is a prefix traversing. So F, C, A, M. Okay. F, C, A, M is the one path. Another path is what? F, C, A, B, M. Got it? There is a first path under M is F, C, A, M is the first path. Now another path is supposed to be F, C, A, B, M. That's what we have mentioned here. You can see FCA, FCA is 2. This value is 2 here. You can see this. Okay. FCA value is 2. Right? FCA value is 2 here. Then another path is what? FCAB. So FCAB here is become 1. M is equal to 1. M is appeared once here. Here in this case, M is appeared twice. This is what M conditional pattern we come up with. Okay. Now, there are all frequent item patterns that include M. You find out all the frequent patterns that include M, right? What are the frequent? You can see like F, F and M, there is a probability of occurring, I'm talking about. There is a possibility sub together, pairs of. It can be two or three or four items. Okay, you can take it like that. So if you take two items, probability that F and M can appear twice, can appear. Probability that C and M can appear, right? Probability that A and M can appear together. Then another probability that F, C, M, three item set together can appear. Another probability is what F, A, and M. If you take this, if you traverse this particular path, if you traverse this particular path, what happens? There is a probability that A and B together it can appear, right? That means under this, right? Yes. Then another probability that F C A M can appear here, because we have not taken a B here, because the reason there is no B here. We have not taken B here because M is comes under FCA, right? That means there is no B here. That is the reason why we left this B item. We are not included here. You can see this, there is no B item here, right? Because B is not in this particular case. This particular, if you traverse this path, there is no B. That is the reason why you left out. So you have taken only whichever is applicable here. So FCA M, right? FC, you can see this, FCAM is another path, right? FCM is another path here. Now, what is the other path is? C, if you traverse this path, I'm talking, if you traverse this path, CAM, right? CAM. This is CAM we have mentioned here. You can see this. CAM is another path. Then you can have one more path. What is the probability of F, A, and M? You can see FAM is another path. What you have mentioned here, right? FAM. F is one item, okay? F, then you have F is the one, then you have A is the one, you have another one is M is the one. So F, A, M is another path. Like this, you have another path here you can come up with. F, C, and M. Another path you can come up with, right? F, C, and M is another path. This is a probability of, you know, occurrence, probability of occurrence that we have calculated here. That means we have derived it. All frequent patterns that include M, that we have come up with. These are the some of the frequent patterns what we have derived here, right? These are the some of the frequent patterns what you have derived here, right? Now, you have to come up with M conditional FA tree contains only path FCA3. Why it is FCA3? It's very simple, right? Why it is FCA3? Reason is, we have a support count. What is the threshold value for the support count is 2, right? Which M value satisfies in this particular case? Only this path can satisfy, right? Because this M is equal to 2, because support count threshold value we have taken as 2, right? That means this case there is a M is equal to 2. So only this path, FCAM, this particular path will satisfy. But this path will not satisfy. FCAB will not satisfy because M value is equal to how much? The occurrence of M is 1 here. Okay, occurrence of M is value, the support count for M. This case support count for 1 is equal to, M is equal to 1 here. This case support count for M is equal to 2. So that is why only this path we have to take it. You have to discard this particular path because it will not satisfies the, when you compare with the support threshold value of the support count. That is why when you form a conditional tree, M conditional FA tree, what happens? We are taking only FCA. That's it, FCA. We can see this FCA. We have taken only FCA here. Other one, we have just FCAM. We have discarded here. Okay. This particular path we have discarded. It will not come because the reason is the support count for M here is less than the threshold value. Threshold value we have taken 2. So 1 is less than 2. So that's why we have not taken this particular one at all. We have taken only this one because it satisfies the minimum threshold value. That is why what we have did, the final conditional FE tree we have constructed is what? FCA equal to 3, right? FCA equal to 3. Why it is 3? See, here FL is 4, right? Why it has become 3 here? The reason is, since this path we are not going to take it, minus one path, that's it, okay? Since this path we are actually not going to take it because it is not going to satisfy as per our support count, okay, threshold value. So there is one path we are not going to take it, just minus one path here is become F is equal to F, F value is, see, support count for F is equal to become 3 here, this case. Okay, that is why FCA is occurred how many times? That is support count for FCA, this particular item set is supposed to be 3. Okay, you got it now? It's a very simple concept. Then, if you calculate for every individual item set, for every individual items, there are many items like F, M, B, A, C, F. There are many items, right? This what the table I have just put it here. For example, P, we already done it. For the conditional pattern base, what actually thing is FCM, this is what we call as a conditional pattern base, FCA, AM and CB. But since CB, which is having, which will not satisfy as per the threshold value, we are going to take it what? Only C. Okay. C is equal to 3. This is what we have discussed in the previous slide, right? C, right. This is what I'm talking about, C3. That's what I updated in the table here. Okay. C3, conditional FE tree. Final conditional FE tree constructed, C is 3. Then, if you take item M, the previous slide, what is this? FCA 3. This is what I have updated in the table here. F 3, C is 3, A is 3. Right? Here the conditional pattern base for this is, for M is what? FCA 2, then FCA B 1. That means the value, the support count for this particular FCA item set is 2. Support count for FCA B is 1. Got it? So since FCAB support count is less than the threshold value, we are going to consider only this particular item set. That's a frequent item set, FCA. This satisfies the minimum threshold value. So that is why I mentioned here. F is equal to 3, FCA 3. This is what we have discussed in the previous slide, right? FCA, this is what an answer we got it. This is what I updated in the particular table. Like this, for an individual set, if you can take it B, will you calculate for the value of B, how it is supposed to get it? Why it is an empty? Can anyone guess it? Guys, anyone update in the chat box? Can you just try with that? I'll just show you the what is the tree for that, okay? For B value, okay, you need to calculate for the B value. I'll show you the particular tree also. Oh, I'll just display it here, tree. Will you calculate for B value, please, anyone? I'll give you 2 minutes of time. Why it has become an empty set? Can you just try? Guys, will you try this? You understood the concept, yes or no? Put in the chat box, yes or no concept. Correct. Absolutely. You are absolutely correct. So you got the process of the procedure how to calculate. Correct. Very simple procedure. Nothing is there. So let us discuss that. What is the, how, why it has become empty set is here. We'll start with the B. We have to calculate for the B value, right? Where is the B? B is present. You need to traverse the path where B is present, right? Where is the B value is present here? This is the B value. This is what the B value here, right? This is what the B value here. Now, one more B value is where? This is the B value. There are two B values here. Of course, we have one more B value here also, right? This is the one item set B. Another B is here. Third B is here. Now, these three, you need to traverse it. How do you traverse it? The traversing is very simple. U actually comes by root, okay? Then comes to F4, then come here. This is the one path. Then another path is what? You come, traverse through F, then comes C, then comes to A, then traverse to B. Got it? Here again, B is equal to 1. What is the support count for B in this particular path is 1. This path, if you traverse this particular path, F and B, what is the support count for B? Is here also 1. Now, when you traverse this particular path, because here is one more B you have, right? You need to traverse this path also. When you traverse this particular path, okay, what happens? Here also, the support count for B is equal to what? 1. You are traversing this particular path. Support count B is equal to, B value is also 1. Now, if you do this, all the B value is 1. What is the threshold value? Is 2. So 1 is less than 2, right? That is why. So whatever you are going to conditional set, what you are going to create or maybe generate is going to be an empty. Because None of this support count will maybe a item set will satisfy that. None of the item set, because here also B is one. If you travel this particular route, okay. If you travel this particular route, is also B is equal to one. If you traverse this particular route, is also B is equal to one. If you traverse this particular route, is also B is equal to one. So one is less than two, it will not satisfy. That is the reason why this supports that whatever the final conditional set what you're going to generate it is what? Empty set. There is no value. Conditional FE tree is which contains the empty. Okay. The same way if you can calculate for value of A also. Okay. Same way you can calculate for A also. How do you calculate for A? Hopefully you can able to understand this A value. How will you calculate? If you can see this particular case, where are the A items? A item, maybe here is the one A item, right? Which is one more A item is? You have, that's it. Only one A item here. What is the route for, what is the path for traversing this? Traversing route is supposed to be what? It goes F, then comes to B, then comes to A. This is what the path we are going to traverse it. F, C, A, right? This is the only one path. That's it. There is no other A, right? This only one path you have it here. F, C, A. This is only one path. So this is where you are going to apply the same rule what you have discussed in the others also. So what you're going to come up with is F3, C3. This is what the conditional FE tree we come up with. Got it now? Because only one path, so A value, the support count for A value there is 3. That is why it satisfies the minimum threshold value. It is greater than the minimum threshold value. So this is 3. Like this, you can calculate for this also. For example, is for F, both are empty. Why it is both are empty? Why is both are empty? If you can see F value here, what is the F value here? You can see F is just under the root here, right? So that is the reason why these are empty, total empty. There is no, it is not derived from anyone. It is just comes under root. That's why the support count for F here, maybe earlier case, here is a 4 here, but it satisfies. But the reason is, since it is the first item just under the root, okay, it's become empty. We are there is absolutely no, you cannot represent any tree under that. So conditional, M conditional tree supposed to be here is empty set. Got it? So it's supposed to be conditional FE tree. What you're going to construct is supposed to be empty set. Okay. This is how a conditional pattern, conditional FE tree can be derived from conditional pattern basis. Just a simple example. Maybe you can try with other examples, which is there in the, maybe I'll give you a homework. Maybe in the assignment, I'm going to give you some of the questions. Same procedure you can follow and come up with the conditional, the table format like this. Okay. Conditional table format like this. I'm going to mention some one or two problems in the assignments. Please do that also. Oh, okay. Hopefully everyone is clear. Please mention yes or no in the chat box, please. This concept is very simple. Can you mention yes or no in the chat box? Simple concept. Yes. Yes, guys. Okay, good. Good. So now this is about base pattern. Of course, why frequent pattern growth is faster? One of the reasons behind is that the performance study shows that FE growth is faster than the a priori. Okay. And it's also, reason is simple, because no candidate generation is here, right? FE tree. There are absolutely no candidate generation. We actually come up with the trees. Because a long pattern, as I told you in the last class, suppose if you have a long pattern, okay, maybe you have a 10 item set, more than 10 item set. If you have a long pattern, a priori algorithm will not work. It is a very complicated actually. Okay. You may not able to come up with that, because every time you have to generate candidate generation. Suppose if it is a 10 item, there may be a chances of generating hundreds of generations, the candidate generation. Practically, it's very difficult. A lot of computational cost will be involved. That's what I told in the last class, right? That is the reason why in FE tree, FE growth is much faster than a priori algorithm. And use a compact data structure, okay? Then eliminates repeated database scan, okay? Eliminate repeated database scan. This is what I told you, because I have taken a value of F earlier. Whenever F appears one more time, what you are going to do, instead of adding one more, or maybe instead of generating one more, candidate generation, which is normally happens in the apiary. But the tree, what happens? Instead of adding one more F value, okay, just wait. one more f value, what I can do, just update the count of f. That's it, update the count of f. And basic operation in a count and FE tree building, this is sum up on why it is faster. Got it now? So let us move on to another very important topic, the last topics. I say I'll finish up in another 10 to 15 minutes. That topic's also very simple topic, then you'll be able to understand. Okay, now this is the one. This is the one which I wanted to wait. New share. Let me go to vertical. Yes. Now we can see my screen. Everyone can see my screen, guys. Mention yes or no. Vertical data format. Can everyone can see the format? Can see the screen? Mention yes or no. Vertical data format, can see? Okay, good. Now we'll discuss what is this vertical data format is. What happens, whatever you discussed, a priori algorithm or whatever it is the previous one, right? Whatever you discussed, okay. We can see it. Okay, that's fine. So here what happens, whatever discussed earlier till now, is we are discussed about only horizontal, right? The value horizontal in the sense, what actually happens? What is the meaning of horizontal? This is how the horizontal is. See, this is a transaction data, what you are represented, right? One of the way you are representing the transaction data. It is not a table form, it is a transaction data we are representing in this particular format. Transaction ID, items that you have mentioned like this. This is what normally call it as horizontal data format. First, we used to come up with transaction ID. Then we are going to find out what are the items mapped onto the particular transaction ID, right? This is what we discussed till now. Now we have another format, we'll call it a vertical format. The vertical format, what happens here, instead of the transaction ID we are going to mention here, what actually comes, you are going to scan individual item set here. Okay, individual item set, we are going to mention it here. And respective transaction IDs, you are going to mention it. What is this? How it is supposed to be? You can see. To come up with the vertical data format, what happens? You transform the data from horizontal to vertical format. With an example, I'll show you. Just you remember the steps here. Okay. First, you need to transform the data from horizontal to vertical format. Then, support count of an item set is the length of earlier horizontal format. The support count is what? Item set. Okay. Item set, support count of an item set is length of TID in this particular case. But there we have taken maybe I1, I2, I3, those items we have taken it, right? Starting with the K is equal to 1, frequent items that are used to construct a candidate K plus 1 item sets. Then a priori properties exploited. Of course, you are applying the a priori algorithm, maybe FET also. But only thing is what you are going to do, the data format, you are going to change it. Instead of horizontal, you come up with a vertical format. Then, no need to scan the database to find the support of K plus 1 item set. Why it is, I'll just explain to you with an example. Then to avoid a long TID, what you can take the difference of it. For example, you have two, for the different item set. For example, this is what an item, I1 and I2, and I1, these three items, it may appear for many transaction IDs. What you can do? Whenever it consists I1, I2, I3 for this, you find out the transaction ID, which will not have I1 and I2 and I1, which will not contain I1, I2 and I3, this transaction. For example, T, maybe if I say I1, I2 and I1, I1 and I2, okay? Which are the transaction ID will not contain, just find out, I1 and I2. For example, transaction ID 500, right? T500, which will not contain I1 and I2 here. Then, which is another one, I1 and I2 will not contain. Transaction ID, maybe we have mentioned here, okay, only I1 and I2. Then I700, right? It will not contain again I1 and I2 here. Okay, so 500 will not contain and 700 also will not contain. So that you have to list it out. Okay, to avoid long TID sets, what you can do, you take the difference of it. That means, which is not there, that you have to list it out. That's it. So I'll just give you an example that you can be able to understand. This is how it goes like this. If you see, this is what the, what you'll call it as the earlier, whatever seen is the horizontal, right? This is the horizontal. Now you need to represent, you have to transform into vertical here. This is how the vertical format, what we have done, right? You have taken item set here. Earlier in the horizontal, what happens? First one, we have taken as a transaction ID. Instead, in the vertical, what you will do, we are taking a item set here. For item I1, which other transaction is appeared? For example, item I1 is appeared in transaction 100, transaction 400, transaction 500, or transaction 700. These are the item, the transactions, item set 1 is appeared. Now, item set 2 is appeared, these are the transactions. Now, item set
3 ಇದು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ನಡೀತಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಜುನ್ ಸರ್ನ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಹೊತ್ತು
there is a background disturbance please can you just mute some of the one
ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ನಡೀತಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಬೇಡ
ಇದು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಎಂಡ್ there is a disturbance please guys somebody is talking in the back end try to mute it from your side try to mute from your side I don't know whose side is just hello
parts varuthalo avaru illa
hello okay can everyone see my this one
sir you can mute everyone
yeah I can hear right and you can see the slide also
yes sir sir you can mute everyone so that no background music voice can be heard.
Yeah that I'm just trying it mute can I mute everyone
wait, yes wait. Yes sir obviously
yaar language
like that
wait mute also bra the yaar yav section kodutare yaar ramkrishna
okay anyway and I request all the participants whenever you are attending for it please try to inform your family members saying that you know that you are undergoing you are actually attending live classes and request them to not to come in between at least for that 1 hour of time okay That's fine. We'll just try to finish off because I'm trying for unmuting because there is an option there unmuting. Okay, anyway, we'll start with this. I'll just check it later. Now vertical data format what you have seen here horizontal data format we have seen it here okay item set i1 i2 i3 i5 i4 I'm trying to unmute it I just where is I'm just where is an option here Dheeraj unmuting option disable participation and
sir previously okay. You have muted everyone I think again you unmuted
oh previously I muted everyone okay
because yes, I'm sir, just, yes sir
I'll just because there is a background now what I will do okay now it's muted right everyone is muted now I think but I think the background this is
no sir not it
okay here what I will do previously I unmuted